working on the Land Rover the last few days over the Easter break, and one of the most recent jobs that I've done is to fit a Roma drive. So I've replaced the old fairy overdrive that was on it. It was getting rather noisy. It'd always been a bit noisy, but not too bad under drive. It was more the horrible whirring noises it made on the overrun. And there was also quite severe clutch judder, or that's what I thought it was. For having changed the overdrive, that's now gone, and I'll show you why very shortly. Anyway, so the Roma drive's in, and we've just been for a test drive, as you saw, which was very successful. It likes a good positive shift, but it runs very much quieter than the ferry unit, and generally makes it a much more pleasant machine to drive. While the floor was up, I've replaced the gaiter on the high-low range louver, which I've now tucked through the matting rather than put it on top, and that's worked very well. And I've also put some heat shield behind this bit. There was a bit of a problem with this side here trying to melt because it's near the exhaust manifold. Yeah, I'm going to take the cover up and you can have a look at the overdrive. So just before I do, this is the unit underneath the Roma drive. As you can see, no leaks. The ferry unit would be dripping by now after a 40 mile run, but that is absolutely spotless. Beauty of the Roma drive is it shares the oil with the transfer case, so it hasn't got a litre in it all the time. Still get a little drip from the gearbox, but that's standard. So here is the Roma drive. I should say that the main difference over the ferry unit is that it's an epicyclic design. The ferry overdrive is fairly complicated with all its needle roller thrust bearings and so on. And this is a much simpler device. It still uses a Land Rover gearbox synchroniser, but otherwise it's a very simple design, very robust. Doesn't even leak around the selector shaft, which is great. Pleasingly, no leaks. As part of the kit, you also get this cover plate here for filling the transfer case and a dipstick. Now, I've actually already had these fitted for a long time. Excellent bit of kit, and certainly from my experience so far of fitting it and driving it, I'd recommend one. Not difficult to fit, very nice design of coupling, much better than the old ferry design. Much more robust, and generally the hardest bit of fitting it was getting the floor up. So this here is the ferry overdrive that I took off the Land Rover. It's an original type. They were you could have them in the end as a factory fit accessory, but they were a Land Rover approved aftermarket accessory. Now the Roma drive isn't, but it's a more recent design, and as I say, epicyclic rather than this old fashion type of design with a separate lay shaft. You've got an input shaft, output shaft, a multitude of needle rollers. The Roma drive does away with all that. And the other difference is that this has its own separate oil sump, as I say. So one of the frequent troubles with these is oil passing the input shaft and going into the transfer case. As I mentioned, I thought there was terrible clutch judder. Turned out to be this coupling causing excessive backlash in the drivetrain. There's virtually nothing left of the splines on that, and the main shaft on the overdrive is worn in the same way. So as you can see, nothing left of that. I reckon that was very close to shearing off. So you can see all that backlash. This is a worn one, but much closer to what it should look like. So you can actually see that it has splines. But they're very fine and they do tend to wear. So this is going to need a rebuild before I decide what to do with it. and it will need the input shelf replacing. Another little job I did while the floor was up was to replace the gear selector lever. As you can see, the bush has come off the end, so the change was somewhat imprecise, shall we say. So I just rebuilt another unit, and it's now back to a nice slick gear change. Anyway, hope you've enjoyed the video, and thank you for watching.